in the picture. We then wanted to go ahead and put back some of the detail, such as the borders, though. So I went ahead and I did a quantize on it, which just gave me nice broad areas of color, and touched out some of the things I didn't want. Here are just a few little dots. And at this point, was able to put back the lines using another really handy feature called Edge Finder. This is a keying operation that actually identifies regions of color and creates a boundary there. So by first doing this and then depositing that in my stencil, I was able to quickly paint back in just the borders. So this is an example, again, of how the tools that Symbolics gives the artist allows him to be more productive. Literally in less than 5 minutes, we were able to go from this image with all of these lines in detail to a final piece that the client was ready to use with just the countries and the borders.
Paste-up mode is a powerful tool for both image composition and the layout of 2D animation.
Paste-up mode is a new feature in the Paint-O-Mation system that gives the artist the ability to lay out and compose images in a way that he's never been able to do before. Basically, each of the elements that you paint with, shapes or brushes in this mode, are independent of each other and can be moved around on the screen, copied, resized, repositioned, and the advantage is that none of the other elements that I've painted with already are affected. This means that if I have an image that has 5 or 6 or more levels, I can change my extreme background level or element without having to redo any of the foreground elements. In this particular case, I've taken one shape, copied it over several times, and used paste-up to move and reposition and resize that one shape that I initially had. Now, looking at this, it looks good. We're getting towards the composition that I want, but I need something for my foreground here. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off paste-up mode here and look at what images I might have which would be suitable for a foreground. All right, here I have an image that I'm going to use as a foreground element. I can use a feature called copy operation to copy just a portion of that image into this scene that we're creating. When I reactivate my paste-up, those elements will automatically place themselves back on the screen where I had laid them. There's really no limit to the number of elements that you put in here, so I want to add a logo to this. The logo was created by using the unified capabilities of this machine that combine 2D and 3D capabilities. I began by frame grabbing a logo to the paint canvas, and then I went into the geometry program and used a feature there called edge detection to create a 3D object from this. As a 3D element, I can then rotate it, scale it, move it around. I'm basically looking for a position that is going to work in my 2D composition. When I've found that, I can output this from the 3D environment back into the 2D program and then add it to my scene or my paste-up. I can just open a slot in the layering and insert the brush where I want it. When I redraw my paste-up then, I can position the brush and voila.
But PasteUp's flexible layout capability is just the start. For PasteUp mode is also the foundation of Symbolics' 2D animation power.
We've taken a look at a number of different features and facilities in the system for creating a range of effects and looks. But the system is called Paint-O-Mation for a reason, and that's because most of the things that I've shown you so far can be animated. A very common thing that we're asked to do is animate logos. So let me show you a very simple, quick example of how we might animate a logo using Paintimation. What I can do is take any shape that I've worked with and paint it on the screen. I can place this in my paste up, change the color, change the position of the object, put that in my paste up as well. Think of these as keyframes in an animation that I'm building. Let's go ahead and do a third keyframe. Here I'm going to change not only the color, but I'm also going to skew it. So I can change its position, its size, its color. And I've placed all of these keyframes then in a paste up that I can use in building an animation.
Ken builds an animation sequence by installing his first sequence element. His paste-up keyframes automatically load in the order they were created. He then specifies the frame number at which each keyframe should be displayed. Any number of operations can be animated simultaneously. In this example, Ken selects a background image to be combined with the keyframes.
Last but not least, we're going to need to record this. So I'm going to go ahead and add another image type operation that's going to save our canvas. And again, here there are a variety of ways that I can save it. I can save it back into an image. I can save it to the symbolics file. I could save it to the abacus, which is what we're going to do. I also could save it via S-Record, which allows me to save it off to a variety of different types of tape devices. But in this case, we're going to use an abacus. We have an interface to the abacus that is very similar to using its keyboard and actually supports segment lists. So I can actually just choose a segment that I've named and I'll record into that section of the abacus disk. We're basically ready now to set up this animation and run it.
Once the animation is set in motion, the finished frames are recorded. This example took about 30 seconds to complete.
Let's go ahead and take a look at that now that we've finished it.
This simple example illustrates Symbolics' approach to 2D animation. Symbolics' power becomes evident as the animation becomes more complex. This animation adds luminance reversal to the moving letters.
This animation was created in much the same way as the original example that I showed you. We've created a sequence that has a group of keyframes for each of the elements that we're animating. So you can see here there's a group of keyframes that will animate the word paint, a group for the letter A for the word animation, and for each of the elements that are animated. We can look at the individual keyframes for any of these elements by clicking on the bar. This shows me each of the individual keyframes that will animate the word paint in this case. The first frame being off screen, the second frame being up above the middle of the screen. And here I can just step through each of the positions that the word will animate to. By clicking on Animate, I'm able to start this sequence running. Here it's animating each of the elements for the frame, recording it, and then going on to the next frame. These frames are taking about 4 seconds each, and that means we'll be able to finish this 40-frame animation in between 3 and 4 minutes. Although the animations we've taken a close look at animate primarily text, there are many different things that can be animated. In addition to the text, I can animate the colors of things. Here's an example of an animation that used recolor in a very clever way to make it look like a flashlight shining into the forest. Any of the items on the menu can be animated, from the loading of background images, the panning of images, to the recoloring of the canvas and brushes. Quite simply, you can paint on the screen, recording your brush strokes, and that can become an animation in itself. Once that path has been created, you can take any of the brushes that you've got and animate them along that path. Here are my original brush, but I can swap and use other brushes. Here, going over the same path, kind of giving it a neon look, or something more bold. We're next going to show you automation, similar to animation in the sense that there are many steps that will be the same on a frame-by-frame basis. But for some reason, our artist may have to interact with the process. Rotoscoping is a good example of a process that could be automated. Several steps are the same every time you do a frame, such as grabbing it in, making a stencil from it. The artist then may paint on some of the picture, and then you record it. So automation deals with automating those steps that are the same on a frame-by-frame basis, but gives the artist control when he needs to do his thing. This is a good example of an animation that lent itself well to automation. Like rotoscoping, there are many steps that are the same and repeated from frame to frame. However, in this case, we begin with line drawings that are done on paper by a cell animator. The process that we use to automatically cut out, colorize, and then place this character over a background has many steps to it.
The sequence list makes it easy to set up complex automation. The computer handles the repetitive tasks and gives the user control when drawing or other input is needed.
Let's go ahead and see what this process looks like in action. So here I've begun it. It loads an image into the canvas. It's first going to pull a soft mat, then it pulls the second mat, drawing on the screen, and now it's given control to me. As the artist, I can now go in, do my area fills, choose another color here for our horns, teeth and eyes. And when I'm done with my area fills, I can give control back to the system so that it can go ahead, do its fine quality line drawing, and then ultimately drop in a background. There are many benefits to an automated process like this. It greatly simplifies my task as an artist by eliminating some very mundane things that I would have to remember, such as what frame am I working on, or what is the next step, or where am I going to record this frame. It also eliminates literally dozens of menu choices that I would have to make for each frame. And so, in addition to simplifying my task, it also speeds up the process.
For any repetitive paint process, from quick turnaround cell animation to high volume diagrams and graphs to intricate rotoscope work, Paintimation's automation gives symbolic artists a winning ride. And for the widest range of paint and 2D animation effects, Symbolic's Paintimation is the unified system solution. Symbolic's XL Animation is a unified high-end 2D and 3D graphics production environment. Here's what leading international graphic artists have to say about Symbolic's.
A lot of systems suffer from a style, if you like. If you watch a sequence, you can often say, oh, that was done on a so-and-so, or that was done on so-and-so.
Well, whereas with Symbolic's, I mean, there's even a hard time sometimes telling whether or not it's computer animation or whether or not it's live video that's maybe had some production, post-production techniques on there.
With Symbolic's, you can often make things look completely different. You can make things look unique.
When I first saw the system and fell in love with it very quickly, one of the reasons why is because it looked very flexible.
Where the system really shines is in the modeler, as far as being able to rapidly create stuff, you know, complicated things really quickly, more than any other system I've encountered.
You can build models and animate them very, very quickly indeed.
and the symbolics had so many options, and the color palette was beautiful, and you could do shapes operations and do animation with the paint system.
I think the best thing about the symbolics is the ease of use, the ease of familiarity. It's very quick to get familiar with it.
What I'd say about the system really is that it does the simple things fairly straightforwardly, but if you want to do more complicated things, you're not limited by the fact that somebody's made it too simple for you.
Symbolics Render has very clear texture maps and reflection maps compared to a lot of other renders out there.
You can set an animation going overnight, sure that when you come back in the morning, it will have rendered it. So subsequently, you can get a good night's sleep. The amount of work we do has just been snowballing since day one. I mean, we're now faced with the prospect of having to get a third system.